Does that motor look familiar? Well, it's not mine. I'm still in Alabama. Came out back on my home lake again with a buddy of mine. I've been being lazy today, been slacking, have not made an intro. Boy, we've been catching them. Y'all about to see that in a second. There's mayflies everywhere. That's my favorite time to fish. You get to pick up a frog, run down the bank, get to sight fish a lot for them, get to see them cruising. It's kind of frustrating though, you don't catch all the ones you see. Enjoy the rest of the video. It's gonna be a fun day. Already has been a fun day. We got a couple hours left. Let's go catch a couple more big ones.
11. Ooh. Spot in the grass. Ain't that a spot?
I'm a freaking node.
Yeah. A little largemouth.
Largemouth.
What kind of hook do you throw on a Senko?
Either like a 4 or 5-aught round bend or...
That dude right there sticks them. Golly, that was a small one anyways. Dadgummit. Be like a 1.75 pounds probably. Thought those were bass. Those are freaking giant bluegill. Some of them brim over there were huge, man. Oh, there's a big bass. Big one. Big one, yeah. I don't think he spilled. Oh, there's 2 or 3. There's 2 or 3. God, he didn't freaking... He didn't really have it. God, I was about to smash him though. Oh, bass coming. Bass coming. Like 5 big ones. Big ones. Real big ones. Big ones, dude. Get you one. Get you one, dude. Big ones. Big ones, dude. Dude, I love doing this, dude. Don't come off when I swing you. Yes, sir. I said 5 big ones coming. That was awesome. Dude, there was 2 bigger than this. Look at that. How about that for it? That'll be my thumbnail right there. If I can grab this. I love doing this, dude. Love Alabama. That's more fun than Chickamauga. Did you see how many was with it?
No, I didn't see him, dude. I saw that one, but I didn't see how
on a frog.
Yeah.
Big one too, I think. Yep. Golly, dude, that's so much freaking fun. Hee hee. I better been recording. Yep, I was.
Oh, you were?
Yeah. Golly, dude, look at that. That's so much fun. Gosh. Come on, dude. That is awesome. Check that out, dude. Big ones on a frog. Don't know yet. Just trying to decide. Oh, that's a big one, dude. That's a big one. You got it, got it, got it, got it. Get him, dude. I got it. Dude, that was awesome.
Oh, it popped out.
This is a stupid thing to him. Freaking big one. 4 pounder. 3¾ at least. Glad you finally caught a big one.
Huh?
I'm glad you caught a big one.
All right, so I just got out of the boat with Cal Culpepper. That's the guy we fish with. He's a buddy of mine. He grew up living on the lake that I grew up fishing on all the time. There's about 4 or 5 of us that really grew up fishing on the lake, fishing all the time. We all know each other. We're all good friends, but we compete hardcore. But I just got out of the boat with him. On the way home now, I'm gonna get home and I'm gonna try to explain to y'all exactly what we were doing today around those mayflies. So give me just a minute. Okay, so mayflies, basically, they don't usually get here in May. They're usually a 1st of June type of deal. And whenever the mayflies are on the lake, that's all I run. I run pretty much mayflies and brim beds. And I have the confidence, if I get the right bites, if I put them all on the boat, I'm usually going to catch a big bag. So basically, I attack a mayfly hatch 2 ways. Number one, always throw a frog. The color to me does not matter at all. I've caught them all from black to white, that color. That's just the color I had with me. And I've caught them on every single color frog. I don't seem to see a difference in anything else. The other way I go with it is a Texas rigged worm like this right here. I've swam a jig around them a lot. Caught a lot of fish doing that. I have, threw a wacky rig around it, weightless Senkos. I've done everything. I've cranked them before and actually caught fish through a prop bait, buzz bait, everything. Basically, that is, I feel like when you pull up and you got the right fish that's ready to eat, they're gonna eat whatever. Pretty much, I go and I try to skip the underhangs with a frog, try to get back into the deepest, darkest pockets of shade I can get into. I don't care if it's 6 inches deep. A couple of the fish we caught today were up there super, super shallow. In the Texas rig, basically, if I back out, if we're on flats or something where there's a lot of mayflies, I'll back out and pitch that Texas rig around to the scattered wood or any kind of docks around or anything, isolated cover kind of out from the bank. That's where I'm going to put the Texas rig or jig or whatever it is I'm throwing. The frog, I skip right up around there under the overhangs, and that's pretty much a 1-2 punch. It was pretty cool today. I hope y'all can see it on video. I saw a 4-pounder cruising, saw it on up beside the seawall, row casted to it, landed perfect, twisted a few times. The fish comes up, just eats the frog, and he's facing me and Cal, and you can see him like this, and you can see the frog hanging out of his mouth in the front, and I was just waiting on him to suck it in the rest of the way, and I was going to set the hook. I never set the hook on him. He spit it out. It floated up to the top. That'd have been nice to catch another 4-pounder. We caught them pretty good today, though, for that lake. It's been taking 9 pounds or so to win lately. Obviously, the other day we caught 14 pounds, and then today we had 2 4-pounders and then a 3, and then I had a 4-pound, had another 4-pounder bite and another 2.5-pounder bite. So we could have had a big bag today for that lake. That's what happens when you're around mayflies. It's feast or famine, though. I've done it all day before and caught like 2 fish. So sometimes it's tough, but whenever it works, man, does it work. Fun day as always, though. I don't really know what causes the mayflies. I know the certain time of year. I don't know if it's water temp or the length of the day or what. I just know that they do hatch, and it seems like whenever the water moves a lot, like if it's been low, then it fills up real fast, then it goes, they'll hatch some. I don't know if that's true or not. This is what it seems to me. So basically, I can't tell you when the mayflies are going to be there. I just can tell you when they are there, the bass are around them. You want to make sure you find the mayflies with the brim popping on them, obviously. When you pull up and see a bunch of brim around, you're going to see bass. And the bass do eat the mayflies. I have seen bass eat mayflies, even 4 and 5 pounders actually eat mayflies. But it just seems like whenever you pull up and there's no brim, there's no activity, there's no bass. It's just like, I guess it's on a bad stretch of bank that's not productive or something. But you find the mayflies, you find the bass, you throw a frog, you're going to get some bites. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. I will see y'all in the next one. One more thing. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I appreciate the guys who comment every time. I appreciate everybody leaving likes. My video's been doing well lately. I appreciate that, guys. Hit that subscribe button.